Garganga Ghat in western UP's Garhmukteshwar, the second stop in our Operation Ganga series. This morning, the ghat is peaceful. People here saw the worst just 15 days ago, when bodies were burnt day and night. Mr. Nagar is in charge of arranging wood at the ghat. He says the situation is much better now.
अब तो कम है, बहुत काफी कम है। अब तो 50-60-70 भी नहीं हो पाती हूँ। लकड़ी की भी दिक्कत आई थी, लोगों को आई थी लकड़ी, लेकिन पूरी करी, ऐसे भी करनी थी हमने।
Mr. Ramkrishna Kewat has been a boatman on these ghats for 30 years. He says never in his life has he seen something so horrible. Things are now getting better, he says.
बहुत बुरी हालत है साहब। पांच पूरी रात पूरा दिन यहाँ इतनी बोडियाँ आई थी, बहुत ज़्यादा जगह भी नहीं थी साहब, यहाँ लकड़ी भी नहीं मिली एक बार को। जब इन लोगों ने बाहर से लकड़ी मंगवा जब लकड़ी यहाँ दी हमें।
Just 15 days ago, this cremation ground worked 24/7. Locals say fires lit up, stretching over half a kilometer. One of the main reasons why people have to bury the dead in eastern UP is the unavailability of wood. We spotted a few people getting their own wood at the ghat and got curious.
अपने गांव से लेकर चलते हैं।
अच्छा, ये प्रथा है।
अरे मजबूरी अगर ना हो गांव में तो अपने यहाँ से खरीद लेते हैं।
हाँ, लेकिन ये कि एक रिवाज है कि
हाँ ज़्यादातर गांव से लाते हैं।
Villagers quick to dismiss any news of shortage, calling it a custom.
So one of the problems that people faced early on was the cost of wood which is used to light the pyre. As you can see that this is a depot where there is wood which is readily available, but the problem that was being faced by a lot of people was that suddenly, because of the high inflow of bodies, the cost of wood was increased. So then the Nagar Palika or the municipality stepped in, and those rates have been revised to be acceptable to all.
Though Garhmukteshwar never faced problems of floating corpses, certainly not the type seen downstream in eastern UP, boatman Kewat says that this is because the administration moved fast upon learning that some ambulance drivers had driven to dump unclaimed bodies.
यहाँ बॉडी डाल के चले गए थे ड्राइवर कुछ, हाँ। ये एम्बुलेंस वाले ही,
हाँ।
तो पुलिस वालों ने आके वो फिर बॉडी जलवा दी थी वो,
मतलब एम्बुलेंस वालों ने ला,
हाँ, वहाँ यहाँ लाकर छोड़ गए रात के लिए, रात के टाइम पे।
पीपल डू कम हियर टू कंसाइन द बॉडीज ऑफ देयर लव्ड वंस टू फ्लेम्स एंड नॉट नेसेसरली डंप देम इनटू द रिवर। वन ऑफ द मेन रीजंस व्हाई दैट इज हैपनिंग इज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस एरियाज प्रॉक्सिमिटी टू दिल्ली। सो टू दैट एक्सटेंट द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन इज एक्सट्रीमली अवेयर that it has to make all the arrangements to make sure that people do not suffer simply because there is a crisis of wood, crisis of availability. So all those things we can conclude the administration has very well taken care of.
Most of the deaths are a result of poor medical infrastructure in rural pockets. Take for instance this village Dopai in Garhmukteshwar. Villagers say there were 35 deaths in the last 22 days. Even this primary health center was shut down because of the panchayat elections. It has now opened, but one really doesn't know what to make of this deserted look. Low cases, hesitancy, or lack of basic medical help.
अगर कोरोना से पहले की बात करें तो ये बहुत ज़्यादा बिजी रहने वाली PHC है, और यहाँ करीब 150 से 200 पेशेंट डेली का है। लेकिन कोरोना टाइम में यहाँ पर पेशेंट कम हो गए थे, और अब फिर से इसको सिर्फ कहें कि फीवर वाले पेशेंट के लिए रोका खोला गया।
Some who have shed vaccine hesitancy now want to get inoculated. They get an inoculation card as well. These ladies leave slightly disappointed upon learning that the gap between their doses have now been increased by a few more weeks.